Hi. Let's talk about the suprarenal glands, kidneys, and ureters. As we've discussed, portions of the urinary system are really dissections of opportunity. And as the kidneys and ureters are located within the retroperitoneum, as are many portions of the digestive system, and as the digestive system would need to be dissected away in order to visualize these structures, we discuss and dissect the kidneys and ureters along with GI. So within the retroperitoneal space, you'll recall that there are anterior and posterior pararenal spaces, which are going to flank the perirenal space. The pararenal spaces are separated from the perirenal space by means of the perirenal or just renal fascia. So superficial to this fascia will be the pararenal spaces and pararenal fat and loose connective tissue. Deep to this renal fascia will be the perirenal space. Let's take a look at that now. So here is the renal fascia, which has been incised. And we can see within it some perirenal fat. Anything outside of this space would be pararenal fat. I always recall that I, perirenal, is inside the renal fascia. We can also see the suprarenal gland here, or the adrenal gland, as well as the kidney here. And the kidney is encased by the renal fibrous capsule. So here is the fibrous capsule surrounding the parenchyma of the kidney. You can also see the hilum of the kidney here. And that hilum is receiving a renal artery, a renal vein. Here's an accessory renal artery. And there is the ureter descending down, conducting urine away. And that hilum is located along the medial border. It's the concave portion of the medial border of the kidney, which is facing anterior medially, and we can see the lateral border facing posterior laterally there. So here we can see the kidney has been dissected some. As you recall, the parenchyma is divided into two portions. There's the cortex and the medulla. The medulla is organized into pyramids, like so. And here's another pyramid, poorly drawn pyramid. There's another one here, located there. Nephrons will be located between the cortex and the medulla, so within both cortex and medulla. The space between medulla is cortex, so those are renal columns, if you recall. Columns will insinuate themselves between the pyramids. And the pyramids here, let me erase this. The pyramids, the apices are papillae. And so what we'll have are collecting ducts that conduct, filtrate down, and then at the papilla, all of those physiological processes of exchange are now halted, and filtrate is now unambiguously urine at the papilla. And so those papillae are surrounded by minor calyces. Minor calyces are going to cup the papillae to receive urine. Minor calyces which we can see here and there, are going to coalesce into major calyces. We can see a major calyx there. There's another major calyx. And there is a major calyx. So we have three major calyces coming together to form the renal pelvis. The renal pelvis. And then the renal pelvis is contiguous with the ureter here. The ureters will conduct the urine down into the urinary bladder within the pelvis. We also have the opportunity here. So this again is the medial border. And we can see the hilum is the concavity of the medial border. But all of this space here, this interleaving space in and amongst the segmental arteries and the conductive pathways, is known as the renal sinus. And that renal sinus is going to be imbued with quite a bit of the perirenal fat or adipose connective tissue, again, because it is on the inside of the renal fascia. So we've discussed a kind of a high-level overview of the proximal portions of the urinary system as well as the suprarenal glands. Thank you very much for your time.